Hi, I'm Steven Dias, and you're watching Superpower Football.
Now you're born in Mumbai, of course.
Right.
How was it for young Steven Dias to come up in Mumbai and, you know, become a footballer? How was your young experience?
Initial stage was little difficult. I mean, you know, Mumbai is all about cricket.
Yeah.
So yeah, initial stage, too much struggle in life, but my family, my mom supported me in football. Yeah. My brother was not supporting me in football, but my mom, she always supported me in football. So I think today I'm a professional footballer, I think just because of my mom.
So all the credit goes to mom.
Yeah.
Mrs. Dias, thank you so much for giving us the Indian Beckham. now since I mentioned the term Indian Beckham, how does it feel when people call you Indian Beckham?
It's nice. I mean, I still don't feel like, you know, I can compare. I mean, Beckham, he's like legend.
You are, and to us, that's okay.
So I always wanted to play like him, so obviously it's really honor to people calling me like, you know, Indian Beckham.
You were number 23. Is there a reason behind it?
Is there a reason? Because when I joined Mahindra, the last number, I was very junior player, so last number I got is 23. And the same year, I played for Indian team. I mean, I never played any junior under team or under 19 or under 23.
Yeah.
I played direct senior Indian and team. So I don't know, that's how I felt, like, you know, that number is really lucky for me.
Superstitious.
I think all the sportsmen are superstitious. Absolutely. So yeah. So since then, I never changed my name.
Yeah, because I mean, as a fan, I always thought that since you called in Beckham, there must be a story behind it.
No,
because Beckham used to wear 23.
Yeah, but he got after me. You
won't believe
it.
I know that.
So that's why I felt like, you know, there must be some connection.
Yeah. The Under-17 World Cup is obviously coming up. Things have changed a lot.
Yeah.
Now, since you have seen both faces, what do you think has changed over the years in Indian football?
Lot of changes in Indian football. Before, when we used to, I used to see also Indian football, I used to like defend always, like, you know, because we used to get scared of like Japan and Australia and South Korea. But now football is changed, like, you know, it's not like, you know, we have to get scared of them. Football has become so fast now, and the play, the fitness and everything. So I think if you see Indian team also, they are doing really good.
What would your advice to a young footballer who wants to get into football right now would be?
I think I want to advise the young football also and the parents also to support, you know, if someone feels football is their passion, I think parents should support him, especially in Bombay, parents don't support kids. So
it's,
I want to tell them, there is, like, you know, they can make their career in football, so support them. And I want to tell the young kids, you know, everybody wants to play for, like, you know, big teams. Play which team where you get to play in 11.
Yeah.
If you join big team and you sit outside, nobody gonna recognize. Next year you will, you know, I know many footballers, they quit their career in football, they join call centers. So I think if they come step by step, so I think they will get the success. So play for small team, play in 11, let people see your talent, and they should offer you, and then come for big team and play in the team, and then, you know, you can be a professional footballer.
Gradually grow into it.
Yeah, and hard work is the, like, you know, there is no substitute for hard work.
India has just won their first AFC qualifier, and the next game we're going to play is Lebanon. And you, of course, scored a goal against Lebanon, a memorable one.
Yeah.
What exactly was going through your head when you scored that?
I mean,
it was a direct corner kick, by the way, just in case.
So it was like corner kick, but I never thought like it will go in again. My aim was like first push where Sunil supposed to run and flick the ball over, score the goal. So I was targeting him, and that ball, it went in the goal. And
what
that was like, I couldn't believe myself, you know, it went in. So yeah, that was really memorable moments for me.
Uday, another fan of yours, says his favorite, your favorite youngster from the current Mumbai FC squad and the whole I-League, your favorite youngsters.
Farooq is there. He's a really talented.
Yes.
He's strong. Yeah. He got right, left, both legs. He can play. Hitesh is a very good midfielder.
Yeah, Yellow Brigade sings about him.
He's a really good. He's a very sensible player. So, I think these two players I can say.
Yeah.
they're gonna be a future star.
Since you mentioned the Yellow Brigade and them serenading you and Hitesh and all the other Mumbai FC players, what is your take on the Yellow Brigade fans?
Yellow Brigade, I mean, I never seen fans anywhere like that in my whole career.
Yeah.
So I feel personally, you know, Yellow Brigade is like a salt, I can say, you know, if there is no salt in the food, no taste. So
that's,
I think, if Yellow Brigade won't come for our matches, home matches, it's very, if you see our result also in the past, I think all credit goes to Yellow Brigade.
Yeah.
Throughout the match, they cheer for us, you know, they motivate us.
Yeah.
So as a player, I'll tell you, Nehru Cup also, when we used to win in Delhi.
Yeah.
So I think because of fans. So that's the same thing happening here in Mumbai. So I think whatever match we are winning, we won last year also, I think it's all because of Yellow Brigade. So I just want to really thank them, you know, all credit goes to them.
Yeah.
So thank you very much, Yellow Brigade.
By the way, now since you've touched the topic of Yellow Brigade, they have a chant for you. You know the words?
I have heard the chanting for me, but then I exactly don't know that.
You're gonna sing it with me?
I will.
I know. Listen, you, Steven Dias, Mumbai loves you more than you will know.
Oh.
And that is for you, Yellow Brigade people.
Thank you, Yellow Brigade. Thank you very much.
Of course, every footballer approaches, you know, their twilight years. You are approaching yours. You're in your late 30s, time to retirement. It's knocking. What is life after football for Steven Dias?
See, I always wanted to be on the football field, and it's very difficult for me to live without football.
Yeah.
So I already done my coaching license, I already done my B license, so I'm gonna do my A license and then professional license, and I don't wanna live my life without football. So I think after football I'll be into coaching.
Okay.
Maybe I want to be a professional coach.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's my aim right now.
So Coach Dias, we're gonna see him soon.
Yeah,
All right. Thank you so much, Steven. It was great meeting you.
Thank you.
Bengaluru FC, you were in the semi-final.
Yeah.
Huge game. How exactly was it? How was the crowd? How was the whole experience?
It was an amazing crowd because we played against Malaysian team. They was a champion in 2015.
Yeah.
So it was a tough game in JDT first.
Yeah.
Then, but Coach said, we will win this match.